It is a pleasure to be here. I'm going to just be very brief and start by actually repeating themes that Bertrand and André have noted, because this wonderful achievement, I mean, really this engineering marvel, touches on four really critical areas for the Department of Energy. They brought them all together into this wonderful system. But one is, of course, solar. Well, that's obvious. Number two, as mentioned, energy storage. Flying at night would be a little bit more difficult without batteries. Number three, energy efficiency and system integration, an enormously important area, of course. And fourth, I would just single out kind of the advanced materials, in this case, the lightweight materials. But those four areas, and the last three in particular, of course, cut across many of the critical technologies we are developing, including, for example, good old-fashioned land vehicles, drawing upon storage and efficiency and advanced materials. So let me just say a few words about some of these elements from our DOE perspective, as they have been so wonderfully brought, so inspirationally brought to us here with this project. On solar, first of all, I should note that, you know, as was mentioned, my career has been mainly at MIT, and at MIT we also had a solar airplane, much lighter than this one, for all, you know, with all due respect. This was a technology in which a novel way of depositing solar electrode material could be applied to just ordinary paper. Then the paper is folded up into a little plane, and no pilot, but it's actually very interesting. There actually is, I would argue, a strong synergy here. What we're talking about is advancing solar technology in many dimensions, going to things like flexible substrates, lightweight. This is important, obviously, for the solar plane, but it's important for lowering the costs of rooftop solar. One of the reasons the current costs are so high is because of those costs of installation with big, heavy systems. I would argue that, number one, a lot of people are going to be surprised 10 years from now at where solar is, and not only in standard applications, but in applications we don't know yet because of the various types of solar technology being put forward. In fact, this morning, I spoke at our annual Energy Information Administration conference, and one of my themes was, you know, we look back 10 years and we say, wow, the world looks really different today. You name it. iPhones, no more, you know, big hero evening news anchors. We get our information in other ways, et cetera, et cetera. But when we look 10 years ahead, we think the world's going to look the same. And it's not. These are examples of the technologies that will make 10 years from now look just as different as it does when we look back 10 years and see the enormous changes that we've had. So that's one point. Secondly, storage. I'm going to flip now, in fact, to vehicles on the ground. Just recently, some of you may have seen, we had an interesting event in which Tesla paid off a nearly $500 million loan to the Department of Energy 9 years ahead of schedule. They're making money. Obviously, this is an expensive car for the mass market, but the base cost has come down by almost a factor of two in 4 years. Consumer Reports rated the Model S the best car they ever tested, not the best electric vehicle, not the best vehicle that year, the best vehicle they ever tested. It is a high-performance vehicle. Now, clearly, we got to get the cost down, got to get the battery cost down, et cetera. But these are technologies that are, as we heard, are on the way. Energy efficiency, systems integration. I won't go through all of these advanced materials, equally important, But I think the message is what I wanted to leave is that if you look at the certainly the departments of energy's research programs and technology visions, it involves many of the same kind of technology advances that these gentlemen have put together in an integrated system to accomplish something that would not have been thought of a few years ago. And again, I believe in 10 years, we're going to see the fruits of all these technologies changing the world. So with that, I want to really end by thanking once again Bertrand and André for their enormously inspirational activity and success. Thank you.